Your campus, your community, your concerns. Reporting the news students care about, you're watching Winthrop Close Up.
Hello, Winthrop. I'm Charles Tennis.
And I'm Lynette Coleman. Thanks for joining us.
The Johnsonian and Winthrop have made national headlines. Yolanda Harrington has the story.
Students packed Tillman in response to a racially charged article written in the November 2nd edition of the Winthrop Johnsonian. Students of all races came out to discuss the article and to listen to others. As you can see here, students are extremely passionate about this topic. The forum was headed by Chad Key, Director of Multicultural Affairs, and Winthrop Senior Christina Alexander, who also wrote a response piece to Byington's article.
One of the issues that was raised with this rally, with this article, is the reluctance of the minority voice to be heard on campus. Every time I turn around, I see more minority, more diversity, but yet I fail to see that being represented in Winthrop.
Byington was present and attempted to answer all students' questions. Students had mixed emotions about the article, but all wanted a solution.
It's very understandable that a lot of people would be moved by the article and a lot of people would have opinions about it, but you know, the whole point of an opinion is to spark conversation.
The next forum will be held Thursday, November 10th at 8 p.m. in Deacon's Auditorium. All students are encouraged to come out and voice their opinions. The forum will have panel speakers from Winthrop Administration, student representatives, and student publications chief staffs. With Winthrop Close Up, I'm Yolanda Harrington reporting.
Next week, we'll bring you an update on this story.
A common question around campus is exactly when does the Winthrop Close Up air? Will Owens be investigated and brings us the answer.
Every week, MassCom broadcasting students work many hours to put the Winthrop Close Up together. They cover campus news, cultural events, and sports, but hardly any students see the product of these efforts. Due to a series of administrative misunderstandings, the Close Up is only aired in academic buildings during evening hours, but now that's changing. MassCom professors are working with Resonance Life to air the show in residence halls on Channel 95, the Eagle Cinema. Some students say a campus news show would be a good addition to the campus cable offer.
If I could watch it on TV, it'd probably be convenient. I'd probably watch it during the morning while I'm getting ready to go to class. Just for something to look at on TV and to know what's going on.
Others say watching campus news would be easier than reading about it.
Yeah, it's a lot easier than reading it because it takes a lot less time. And you can even do your homework while watching it, you know, instead of just like reading it. And
reaching the residence halls is only a first step for the close-up, as the MassCom department also hopes to show it in Dinkins and eventually on local cable. With photographer Harley Huntington, I'm Will Loinsby reporting.
One Winthrop vice president gets the chance of a lifetime helping out with the country's future. Dr. Frank Ardiola, vice president for student life, will be acting as an official observer for the Liberian elections. He'll be assisting the elections as an international polling supervisor in a presidential runoff that should lead to peace in the country. Dr. Ardiola will return to his office November 14th after the elections have finished.
Stay with us when we return.
We'll tell you how you can turn your used clothes into profit.
And we'll profile the Office of Multicultural Student Life.
So
because not any other sorority out there has that principle. It has to do with the way that Azeta carries herself, the way she presents herself to the community, and the way that she acts when in the public eye and also in private. It's an internal principle that not many women have. That's why not every woman can be a Zeta woman.
I'm not ready to duck.
Kelly, can you handle this? Michelle.
It's that time of the year again. Time to put away those summer clothes and get ready for winter. Megan Goings tells us how the Schoolhouse Exchange can help.
College students can always use extra cash, and considering minimal closet space on campus, students can definitely appreciate the Schoolhouse Exchange. This consignment shop buys and sells just about anything you can find in a student's closet.
We take everything from record players to, you know, clothes and all kinds of accessories for guys' clothes and girls' clothes, you know, purses and shoes and jewelry.
Cody here visits the store regularly to keep the cash and credit coming.
Spend about usually $40 on average a week, mostly on pants, polos, sweaters, and records. Most of that which is in cash, but about usually trade about $10 worth of clothes in a week.
The Schoolhouse Exchange, located off Herloing Avenue, is a great place to trade in or buy from. Either way, you'll be making room in your closet while making money or buying something you've always wanted.
So don't forget, you can save here at the Schoolhouse Exchange on your gently used items. With photographer Tony Moore, I am Megan Goings reporting.
Winthrop students put their talents on stage with hopes of taking home the 2005 Showtime at the Apollo title. Yolanda Harrington has more.
It's that time of year again. Alpha Kappa Alpha at Winthrop University hosts their annual Showtime at the Apollo. This event is different from the Apollo seen on television, but also has the same structure and gives students the opportunity to showcase their talents. Apollo has a rich past here at Winthrop and in history.
Apollo is the goddess of art, and basically Apollo started back during the Renaissance era, and it gives people an opportunity to display their different arts, whether it be singing, dancing, spoken word.
AKA has been sponsoring Apollo since 1992 on Winthrop's campus, and this year 8 student contestants displayed their talents to be judged by the audience. Quadre Reeves, a second year participant, hopes that students find spiritual inspiration from his act.
I hope that the audience be with me and back me up and see that this is a spiritual song that I will be singing. And I hope I touch someone and actually be anointed to them.
Various talents included song, spoken word, and dance, although the crowd was not impressed by all contestants, and some were booed on stage. But in the end, the audience decided, and the 2005 Showtime at the Apollo winner is Antoine Chance. He won a $100 grand prize and a chance to perform again at the 2006 Showtime at the Apollo.
I'm here with the 2005 winner of Showtime at Apollo. Antoine, how does it feel being the winner?
It feels good. I mean, you get a little bit of booze, but it was okay. It was a lot of fun, and I'm glad I won, so.
What are you gonna do with your $100 grand prize?
I would say I was gonna save it, but nah. I think I'm just gonna go splurge it on something, you know, shoes, clothes, something. You never know.
Do you think you can teach me any of your winning moves?
Yeah, I can teach you a little chicken head, you know.
Get it. All right. Well, that's all. I'm Yolanda Harrington with the Winthrop Close Up.
What had Winthrop students shouting and stomping this weekend? Michelle Nolens has the answer.
Students came together to make a joyful noise on Sunday at the 3rd Annual Gospel Explosion. The Lambda Kappa Chapter of Sigma Gamma Rho Sorority, Incorporated hosted the event, which took place in Tillman Auditorium. Proceeds from the event went to Hurricane Katrina victims. Performances ranged from musical acts to interpretive praise dances. Some acts included the singing group Prosperity, AOE's Vision of Zion Praise Dancers, and the Rock Hill High Gospel Choir, just to name a few. Students were thrilled to have a night away from papers and stress to join in the praises of the Lord.
I believe that it was a blessing to all who came. I hope that everyone who came got something out of it. The praise dancers to the singing was just awesome. And if you missed it, you missed a great thing.
The format of the Gospel Explosion changed slightly this year with the addition of a Master of Ceremonies. Pastor Herbert Crump, who's the minister at Freedom Temple Ministries in Rock Hill.
I think it's a wonderful event, much needed event, and something that we look forward to for next year.
The program being such a success, the president of the sorority expects for this to continue to be an annual event.
It's about something that we can all share. So this is something that we're definitely going to continue. It's going to be a legacy for my chapter.
With the number of soulful performances, it's no wonder that Winthrop students will have a lot to shout about. With photographer Charity Jackson, I'm Michelle Nolan reporting.
Winthrop's Office of Multicultural Student Life has been busy lately. James Beach tells us more about this campus department.
The Office of Multicultural Student Life has been in existence for just over a decade, and while expanding a variety of its programs, some students are unaware of the office's mission.
Well, I would say if there is one core goal, it would be to provide opportunities for students to experience something different.
The office strives towards its goals by providing programming such as Hanukkah, Real Conversation Forums, More Than a Month, and Kwanzaa.
And this year, actually, we're successful in getting the founder of Kwanzaa, Dr. Milana Karinga, to come to campus this year on November 29th.
Students interested in becoming involved in the Office of Multicultural Student Life should stop by 107 Dinkins or visit the web address below. With photographer Lenata Coleman, I'm James Beach.
Stay tuned. Coming up, Tony Moore gives us the Eagle Sports Update.
And we've got your cultural event update. Stay tuned.
Exchange of knowledge and to provide a vehicle for people with similar interests to get together. So anybody that's interested in anything dealing with computing is welcome to come get involved. Computing has many different aspects to it, so we're willing to address any of those aspects. We've had gaming contests. We've had national speakers that speak on very involved research problems. We have people that talk about ethics.
Faith in you is blind. It's not to anything that's true. 'Cause your love opens up my eyes.
Hello, I'm Tony Moore, and welcome to the Eagle Sports Update. With only a few weeks before the start of the basketball season, the athletic department is trying to build up excitement. Chasing Tennis has more.
Students and members of the Rock Hill community got their first taste of Winthrop basketball this year as the Eagles hosted the 2005 Band Fest. Both the men's and women's team were introduced to the public, and fans also had a chance to meet some of their favorite players. Big Stuff was also there to greet Little Eagle fans and show off his dance class. There were also performances by the Winthrop dance team, cheerleaders, and the Screaming Eagle band, and even a sumo wrestling match. The event also featured the second annual faculty staff basketball game. The Garnet team defeated the White team 18-10. The game allowed Tom Moore, Vice President of Academic Affairs, to do his best Greg Marshall impression. Others were given the opportunity to act like pro athletes for one night.
just oh, my days are long beyond me. I was just hoping to, you know, play, have some fun, not get hurt.
The women's team showcased their skills by running shooting drills, while the men's team showed off with the dunk contest. The night capped off with an autograph and photo session with both teams.
The Winthrop basketball teams hope that fan support will continue throughout the season. The women's team opens their home schedule November 18th, while the men's team hits the Coliseum floor November 26th. With cameraman Charles Tennis, I'm Jason Tesh reporting.
Terrell Martin has yet another honor to add to his resume. Martin has been named to the CollegeInsider.com Mid-Major All-American team. He, along with 24 other players, were selected for this preseason team by a committee of Division I coaches and assistants. The men's soccer team was in action against a Big South Conference opponent. LaToya Mays has the highlights.
The Winthrop men's soccer team played UNC Asheville in the Big South Conference on Wednesday. It was the final Big South Conference matchup for both teams, but Winthrop came out on top with a 4-0 win. Wayne Osborne, Winthrop midfielder, is proud of the team's victory.
We finally started playing as a team, and that's the main thing that we've been trying to work on all year.
The Eagles started off strong, scoring the first goal in the first 14 minutes of play. The intensity and sharpness led the team from goal to goal. The Eagles played hard this season, which made their coaches proud.
Proud of our freshmen that came in and contributed heavily. Really happy for our senior group. Hopefully going out, you know, last night, tonight on the field and getting a win.
This win over Asheville puts the Eagles 10-6-1 overall and 4-2-1 in the conference. With the Big South Conference on the horizon, Winthrop traveled to Mercer for the closing game of the season. With photographer Britt Mitchell, I'm LaToya Mays reporting.
Winthrop recently hosted the Big South Women's Soccer Tournament. Although they were a generous host, the women's soccer team was dismissed from tournament play. The Lady Eagles fell to number one seeded UNC Asheville with a score of 1-0. Missing your gridiron glory days? Winthrop's got your football fix. Matthew Yarborough has more on this story.
Winthrop University gives students the chance to achieve gridiron glory as Winthrop hosts flag football intramurals. This widely played sport is hosted by the Department of Recreational Sports and pits student teams against each other.
This sport in particular is one of the most participated sports nationwide at colleges.
Although the players shake hands at the end of the game, it is still a competition.
Have a lot of fun, but we're competitive too.
This year, the girls get their chance to shine on the field too.
It's awesome. I am very excited about it. I played flag football in my undergraduate University of North Carolina, Wilmington, and I was really excited about getting a team together and getting a league here at Winthrop.
These events give Winthrop students the chance to show their skill at tossing around the old pigskin while having some fun.
The best teams will represent Winthrop in the regional intramural finals in Wilmington, North Carolina. For photographer Karen Little, I'm Matthew Yarber reporting.
The men's golf team ended its fall season on a sour note. The Eagles placed 13th at the ODU Seascape Collegiate Tournament. Steve Alminas tied for 7th place after taking 142 in two rounds of play. The women's golf team is currently one shot off the lead at the TPC Virginia Beach Invitational. Aaron White is atop the individual leaderboard by one stroke. The Lady Eagles will be in action for the next 2 days as they try to remain in the lead. That's it from the sports desk. Now here's your cultural and community events.
Thanks, Tony. Currently, you are tuned into your cultural and community events. I'm Emery Glover. There's a lot of activities happening on Winthrop's campus, so let's jump right into the fun. Students and faculty were given a chance to hear lovely melodies being played from Winthrop's historic organ. LaVaris Clark hits all the right notes on this event.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound, especially when talking about the D.B. Johnson Memorial Organ. Shirley Fishburne, fundraising co-chair of the Organ Restoration Campaign, returned to Winthrop to perform a recital on this historic organ.
The builder who built this instrument was a master.
And I think this instrument attests to that. And we really want to keep this instrument in the shape that it's in. We've got to bring it up to this century.
The recital, one of many, was to raise awareness of the restoration fundraising drive.
It's like taking care of your grandparents to be a part of this campaign. You know, I really feel that this instrument has taught me so much that I want to give back to this instrument and to Winthrop.
It will cost an estimated $400,000 to fully restore the organ. The 50th anniversary of this historic organ showed everyone who attended the magic behind the music. With photographer Matt Yarborough, I'm LeVar's Clark reporting.
Last Friday, WINR satisfied students' craving for indie rock. A show featuring The Verdict, Ben Barnes Jazz, and Michelle Allen was performed for students. Both WINR and the Anthology sponsored the concert, and the next event they will host will be on December 3rd. In other musical news, Winthrop Guitar Ensemble put on a concert for the Winthrop community. Winthrop Close Up was there and brings us the story.
Two groups of guitar players nearly packed the Barnes Recital Hall as they put on their annual Jazz Guitar Ensemble concert. Under the direction of Dr. Lewis Dickert, the ensembles performed selections from various genres, including blues, funk, and jazz. Throughout the semester, the guitarists practiced diligently so that the concert would be a success.
Well, all of us put in a lot of practice time, not just on these tunes, but in the style in general, and jazz is something that, you know, a lot of guys don't even know when they come to Winthrop. They start learning the craft.
This was the band's first time playing the entire set together. The guitarist had been practicing throughout the semester, but had not gone through the set with a live rhythm section.
With different people touring, big name acts, pretty much you do a quick rehearsal, run through parts of the tunes at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, then at 8 o'clock that night you play. And that's what these guys are getting a chance to do.
This style of practice didn't seem to hinder the musician's performance, nor did it hinder the size of the crowd that came to listen. Students came out not only to enjoy the music, but to show the performers their support.
And I know all of the guys that are up there playing, so just kind of come support my friends and listen to good music.
The night was thoroughly enjoyed by the performers and the audience. The ensemble series is just one of many performances offered by the music department. Check the cultural events calendar for upcoming events.
Can you keep up? Winthrop's Dance Theater will host a dance recital later this week. This production will feature a broad array of dance styles and promises to introduce an innovative approach to the world of dance. The show will open November 9th. The cost of this event is $5 with your student ID. Barnes Recital Hall was filled with lots of people and the sound of music. Karen Little has more.
Winthrop's music department hosted duo pianist Janice Bradner and Tokumo Deguchi for a faculty recital. Deguchi was thrilled to see so many people in attendance.
I love to play great music and then introduce these music to audience.
Bradner enjoys to make music with others.
I felt like each of us had interesting parts. It wasn't one person accompanying and one person playing a melody or both of us playing the same things. I felt like the parts went together.
The performance included a musical piece written by Ronald Parks, who was in attendance. Parks was honored to hear his own composition played at Winthrop.
It's my good fortune to work with two very, very talented performers.
The duo also played works from Darvis Mahan, Johann Sebastian Bach, and Sergei Rachmaninoff. Winthrop's music department will continue to host performances throughout the fall semester. For more information, please go to www.winthrop.edu. With Matt Yarbrough as photographer, I'm Karen Little reporting.
Are you up to date with your cultural events? Well, check out this list of upcoming programs and events going on around campus.
thanks for tuning in to this week's segment of Cultural and Community Events.
Thanks, Emery. That's news happening at Winthrop. Now, here are some stories that have campus talking. Concern for gas prices have increased while oil company profits have skyrocketed. Problems have occurred due to the increase in overall gas prices. A windfall tax may be established, which will target oil companies directly. Congress hopes that this tax will curb the oil companies' price gouging while redirecting those funds into energy assistance programs.
After the deaths of two teenagers in a Parisian suburb of France, a time of civil unrest has created rioting in the streets. Residents blaming police for the deaths protested while local law enforcement worked to gain control of the neighborhood. During the rioting, both the local school and the community gymnasium were destroyed, along with thousands of cars.
Police in Australia clamped down on terrorists and found some in Melbourne, preventing a huge terrorist attack in South Wales. Six people were taken into custody during a counter-terrorist operation, but not charged. Police are currently searching in the suburbs of Melbourne and Sydney for evidence of terrorist activities. We sent our man on the street to get students' reactions to the controversy surrounding campus and the Johnsonian. Here's what you had to say.
I believe the opinions expressed in there are fairly ignorant and stereotypical. I believe any time that you class an entire group as having only one action, one belief, one opinion, just that's not a good thing.
First of all, I commend her for having the courage to put her opinion out there, but I did not agree with it. She, being a black woman, that's all I saw her as from the beginning. I never knew that she was of mixed race. She's a black woman, and I feel that she's deprived because she knows nothing about her black culture.
Well, my own personal opinion is if you're going to take a stand on something, that you need to stick to what you were originally saying. You need to pick one point, and that be it.
I feel that I really didn't like the things that she said, but I feel if she was going to talk about that topic, she could have approached it in a more positive way than she did.
She needs to be made aware that it was not proper for her to do that, and she should never do that again.
That's all for this week's Winthrop Close Up. Join us next week for our last show of the semester.
Well, we'll bring you a behind-the-scenes look at the Winthrop Close Up.
I'm Charles Tennis.
And I'm Lynetta Coleman. Thanks for watching, Winthrop.